One of the many places in Fate that doesn't get a lot of airtime is the reverse side of the world, which really is a shame because there's a lot of interesting things going on in that realm that we never really get to see. Today we're going to dive in on that topic. So, what is the reverse side exactly? Basically, when it comes to the Fate world, you have different layers to the earth called textures, and one of those textures happened to be the reverse side. In essence, you could say that it's a flip version of the normal world on a greater magical plane. Taking the real world, for example, you have the crust that we exist on as humans, and then you have the inner layers of the earth that we couldn't possibly go to because the earth's core is like 9,000 degrees, and if we got even a fragment of being close, we would be burned alive. The reverse side operates in the same way. It is a layer of earth that humans can't normally go to because the magical energy is so dense that if we did go there, we would flat out explode. So when it comes to the beings who can go there, it mostly aligns with them being a magical beast or an entity that has some sort of divine-like power. As you guys know, Shiro ventured to Avalon at the end of the Fate route. Avalon is located in the reverse side of the world. So for him to even get there would imply that he eventually acquired some type of divine presence. Now I'm sure you guys are all aware of how mages move. They love messing with things that they really don't need to mess with. And with that in mind, even though we're not supposed to go to the reverse side, there is said to be an entrance below the clock tower that leads to their realm. This is the spiritual tomb of Albion. The El Molloy series speaks on this several times in greater detail. Taking it all the way back to 0 AD, there was a separation in the world that separated the Age of Man from the beings in the Age of Gods. After that, all the beings that survived the Age of Gods and the laws that governed them were then placed on the reverse side. So when you get over there, you can expect to see some phantasmal beasts, divine spirits, fairies, you name it. But I highly suggest that you don't go over there without a reservation. I'm more than certain that they're not looking for any visitors. And during the time that the separation took place, there was a dragon named Albion that actually missed his flight to the reverse side of the world. So he tried to physically dig his way to the other side. Turns out it didn't work. And in doing so, his body became infused with the earth's crust. Now his tomb is used by the association to discover supernatural resources that you can't get anywhere else. And then they go on to sell them for a high price. And once you get to the bottom of this cavern, there is where you'll find your entrance to paradise. And the reason that they know this is because the deeper you go inside the cavern, the stranger things become, to the point where you start to see creatures from the reverse side, such as the phantasmal species. Knowing about this tomb, the Mages Association figured, oh man, we can't let anybody else find out about this. So they built the clock tower on top of the dragon and used its tunnels to operate their own personal facilities. Now there are more finite ways to get to the other side, but there's a lot of hoops and hurdles that you gotta bypass if you wanna play the part. If you look at the Case Files anime, we get a glimpse on how a portal can be created so long as the traveler has the correct resources. Trevor, who is a particular magus from Case Files, used his own son's mystic eyes to get into contact with the fairies on the reverse side. This allowed him to open up a temporary gate. He started manipulating their power, killing humans, turning these humans into his artificial magic dogs. This man was out of control. And then one of the fairies killed him. Grand opening, grand closing. Now we're often told time and time again how difficult it is to get to this layer. Then you have times where people just escort themselves right in. As I mentioned before, Shiro was able to get there in Fate, but we all know Shiro is a little insane, so not really a surprise there. And the time that it took him to get there is pretty indefinite. Then you have the situation with the main character Sig and Apocrypha, who took the entire Greater Grail to the reverse side to save humanity. Due to the fact of Sig taking on the identity of Siegfried, he has access to Fafnir, and Fafnir is a phantasmal beast, which is the reason that he was able to get in with no problem. Sig isn't human to begin with, so if anybody was able to get in, he'd definitely be one of them. Now, I'm not sure why they made it look like he was taking a trip to Dubai, but we can assume that he was heading towards a clock tower when he had the Grail. Then you have the situation with Joan of Arc. Under normal circumstances, humans can't go, but there are certain scenarios where spirits might have a chance. And if you look at the material for Apocrypha, it says that after an infinite number of times, Joan was able to force her way out of the throne of heroes and directly into the reverse realm. Keep in mind that the throne of heroes is a location that exists outside the axis of time. So I'm very curious to know how Joan was able to just bust through the wall like she's the Kool-Aid man. You have the situation with Merlin, who is still in Avalon right now and just projects an avatar to fight in his stead. You have the situation with Bedivere, where he made it to the reverse side and met up with Merlin after traveling for several centuries. Several centuries? This man is confirmed to have legs of steel. I would never challenge this dude to a foot race. Are you kidding me? And one more thing that I wanted to cover before I head out is the reason that the human world and the reverse world are even able to stay separate is because of the effects of the divine construct Rongo Miniat. This is the same phantasm that belonged to Arturia and her descendant Gray. More than just being a weapon, Rongo Miniat acts as a pillar that holds the texture of these worlds together. Without this, they would fall apart, and then we'd be right back where we started. I'm really hoping that they get into a little more discussion about the tomb, but the Case Files anime only covered the first portions of the series, and the tomb discussion doesn't really take off until around the 8th novel, so we might be waiting for a long time. Type Moon always seems to have tricks up their sleeves. We'll see. Let me know what you guys think. Like the video if you enjoyed it. Shout out to all the patrons, and I will be back with more Type Moon content. It is your boy Sia. I'm out.